right? They sound the same, but it's just an S at the end, right? They're two different things. And it doesn't make sense to tell you the difference between the two without telling you the history of one, right? So Afrobeats grew out of Afrobeat. Now, Afrobeat was created by Fela Anikulapo Kuti. But people also call him Fela Kuti because that name is very long. I'm trying to get as close as possible as what was so that you can actually get that feel. Does that make sense? Now, what Afrobeat music was, he infused jazz, high life, and some other sounds in Nigeria at the time and created his own genre. Fela, like I said, he was very outspoken and very like strong in like being self, and he was also really strong with sexuality. The movements that the women would do on stage while he sang were very, very sensual. There was a lot of rolling. Those are the original twerkers. Yes. The original mamas of twerking. There was rolling, there was shaking, they had floor movements, they had kicks, they had all of that. Okay, so we have all these cool stuff that grew, and now we all do it, and Instagram makes it easy and accessible to get into it. But this, what we're gonna do today, is the beginning of everything. Make sense? This is where it came from.
We'll be right back.
all the oppressive regimes back then in Nigeria, and through his music, he did it before, as advocacy, right? Speaking for the people, and obviously, at that time, it was the military regime, they were extremely, and they did so many bad things, and he would always speak about it in his music. Literally every song he sang was saying, exposing what they were doing or how they were treating Nigerians at the time. Obviously, they didn't like that, and he suffered very big for that. He was put in prison. His house was burnt down with his mother inside of it. They threw her out the window, and she broke her legs. But still, he went to prison, came back, and still kept fighting with his prison. So, the origin of Afrobeat is advocacy. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Everything makes sense. There's a reason for each song. And like, he stood for not caring about what's gonna happen, the consequences. He just had to get his truth out. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Especially at a time where people were scared. The music itself was meant to fight oppressors, right? He was rebelling against all the oppressive regimes back then in Nigeria. And through his music, he was doing it before, as advocacy, right? Speaking for the people. And obviously, at that time, it was the military regime. They were extremely, and they did so many bad things. And he would always speak about it in his music. Literally every song he sang was saying, exposing what they were doing or how they were treating Nigerians at the time. Obviously, they didn't like that. And he suffered very big for that. He was put in prison. His house was burnt down with his mother inside of it. They threw her out the window and she broke her legs. But still, he went to prison, came back, and still kept fighting with his prison. So, the origin of Afrobeat is advocacy. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Everything makes sense. There's a reason for each song. Afrobeat is more about the music than it is about the dance. The dances have their own styles. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. What Afrobeat became, it grew out of that sound and became music to suppress the problems, to block it out. So things started not saying, or talking about what's going on anymore, rather talking about how you need to have fun, right? At the time, Nigeria was going through so much, we didn't want to deal with that. We needed something to make us forget, right? So we moved from talking about the issues in our music to blocking it out with the music. Now, Afrobeat grew out of that and got influenced by pop music and hip hop and everything else from the West that we started to add. And that, at the time, was called Afrobeat dance. And these women were called the Kalakutaku. Now, we do Afrobeat, right? This is a very touchy subject because everyone has their opinion about what Afrobeat dance is, if it's even a thing or not. Yeah. What we call Afrobeat dancing is social and street styles for them. Right? Now, that's also not necessarily true because Africa is a big continent and not every country in Africa does that. Does that make sense? We have each country has their own style of dance or form of dance or genre of dance. Yes? We have, Nigeria has for the street dances, we have our Shango style, Ghana has Azusa style, Kujuros from Angola, and so on, Bitkali from Ivory Coast. We have all these different countries that have their own style. Yes? So if you find yourself in an Afrobeat class, someone tags their class Afrobeat, and you go in there and you're seeing compilation of these different moves or styles, and your teacher can't properly tell you what that is and why they're calling it Afrobeat.